Sure, we all know Elvis Presley as the king of rock, a movie star, a fashion icon, an ass-kicking vigilante turned secret agent. Meet Agent Elvis, the new king of adult animation. Bold claim, yes, but there's simply never been a show like this before, streaming on Netflix or otherwise. Why are we so hyped for this groundbreaking new series? An incredible collaboration. The sheer talent and experience involved in the creation of Agent Elvis is staggering, reaching far beyond its renowned voice cast. This is a witty, mature comedy filled with sex, drugs, and plenty of rock and roll, but it's equally a fast-paced action series filled to the brim with heart-pounding fisticuffs and firefights.
That was amazing. What was all that?
Oh, that, yeah. You know, that was a rehearsal. It's what I'm doing for my new TV show.
Jesus, is that guy okay?
Oh, yeah, that's just fake blood, everybody, and that there's fake, well, whatever that is.
Who better to act as head writer than Mike Arnold, a writer for Archer? We dare say we're in good hands for an adult animation, Secret Agent Romp. Clever adrenaline-fueled script, check. But how does the show look? Absolutely gorgeous, outside of, you know, the disgusting bits.
Your ass needs to see a doctor. And I mean like a ton of them.
This is thanks to incredible animator Robert Valley as creative designer. Valley is part of the illustrious cadre of animators on the cutting edge of the industry, lending their talents to Netflix's Love, Death, and Robots. His episodes, including Season 1's Zima Blue and Season 2's Ice, the latter even won the Canadian an Emmy for Outstanding Individual Achievement in Animation. But Valley didn't design everything in Agent Elvis. Next to his music, the King of Rock is arguably best known for his impeccable style and amazing fits.
Wow. That actually looks way better on you than it did on me, honestly.
Yeah, like nobody saw that coming.
Okay, well, who could consistently capture such a look? Enter John Varvatos, the luxury menswear designer whose work is world famous for its casually elegant, comfortable, and eclectic style that incorporates a bevy of influences from, yep, rock and roll. Yes, a 2D animated wardrobe was designed by one of the greatest fashion designers of the modern era.
You know what? I actually make this look not ridiculous.
The show is created by Priscilla Presley herself, an absolute icon in her own right. She understands better than anyone Elvis's dream of being a superhero. Agent Elvis is a chance to finally manifest that dream, her involvement ensuring Elvis's legacy is properly represented in the thrilling new show. Co-creator of Agent Elvis is John Eddy. Who the hell is John Eddy? An outright rock star with his own decade-spanning career highlighted by singles like 1986's Jungle Boy and best friend of Priscilla Presley. Rock and roll music is clearly at the heart of the series, and it shows throughout its stellar soundtrack. A show about the King of Rock is going to feature at least one Elvis song per episode, which it absolutely delivers. It never ceases to cause chills when hearing Elvis Presley's actual voice within the series, captured perfectly in time, and just as enrapturing as ever. Unifying these creative visions as executive producer of Agent Elvis is none other than Fletcher Muell. Muell is best known for his direction of Enter Galactic, the animated romantic comedy musical odyssey from the mind of Kid Cudi, which debuted on Netflix fall 2022. Highly stylized, vibrant, and beautiful, Enter Galactic more than proves Muell's flair for utilizing animation at its fullest to build rich worlds, paint complex characters, and tell adult stories that rise above any preconceived notions of genre. More than animation. It's clear with this level of talent and attention to historic detail that Agent Elvis has the makings of a show that transcends any limitations that many have unfortunately and falsely associated with animated titles. As Guillermo del Toro says, animation is cinema. Animation is not a genre for kids, it's a medium. Alongside masterpieces like del Toro's Pinocchio, Agent Elvis hopes to further dispel such myths and further prove Netflix's dedication to providing a home for high-quality animated stories. Speaking of animated works of art, the studios behind Agent Elvis have all the momentum needed to create a new king of comedies. From Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse to Vivo, Sony Pictures Animation has curated a steady streak of incredible films for nearly two decades. Although many titles in their library aren't specifically targeted to children, Sony Pictures Animation has never specifically dabbled in purely adult animation. And Agent Elvis is very, very adult. It takes a village to make a show like Agent Elvis. Sony Pictures Animation collaborated with production company Titmouse to grant the show its unique, polished look. perfectly balancing the writing's outlandish comedy and explosive action. Titmouse could be called the animation studio for adult animation. On the Netflix side of things, Titmouse is best known for massive hits like Big Mouth and The Midnight Gospel, but their storied and delightfully controversial catalog dates back decades. Sony Pictures Animation also worked closely with Authentic Brands Group to utilize the many iconic Elvis songs and intellectual properties in the show. As manager of Graceland itself, Authentic Brands Group's involvement and cooperation further solidifies Agent Elvis's dedication to keeping the show as authentic to the Elvis legacy as possible. Cast and cameos. Alright, there's simply no way to gloss over this legendary cast. Many have already heard that Elvis is voiced by Matthew McConaughey, an Oscar-caliber Elvis performance. Who'd have thought?
You boys stay with the car, which means not buying coked-up hookers, he said really clearly this time.
But McConaughey is far from the only award-winning cast member. You also have Don Cheadle as the commander within the Central Bureau, or TCB.
If it wasn't for TCB, half of you'd be toiling in a Japanese salt mine right now, and the other half would be selling fetish sex for food in a Soviet workers' paradise.
What's fetish sex?
Oh, kids are so stupid.
Caitlin Olsen is a riot and scene stealer, a sharp-tongued agent CC Ryder, totally immune to the charms, and especially music, of the king.
The name Charlie Manson mean anything to you? Absolute psychopath. Who, small side note, technically just kidnapped your friend.
What?
The one not wearing a diaper, Bobby Ray.
Oh, the fucking waiter just tell you that?
Oh, did the fucking waiter Yeah, we've got eyes everywhere. Creepy, right?
Johnny Knoxville nails the controlled chaos of Bobby Ray, the ultimate pal to accompany Elvis on dangerous missions and balance out all that laid-back sexy swagger.
Hey, they may be coming back soon.
So let's get you out of here.
What? No, I mean to fuck me again. Seriously, E, these batshit crazy free love chicks are on fire.
Is that blood?
Okay, yeah, the sex got a little dark. Not proud of it, but I'd do it again.
Niecy Nash, hot off her Emmy-winning performance as Glenda Cleveland in Dahmer, is the perfect birdie, unafraid to tell off Elvis or any secret agents when things get a little too out of control, which they always do.
Which house rule am I thinking about right now?
Definitely not the one about personal space.
You promised none of your vigilante nonsense in this house, remember?
Won't even know we're here, Miss Birdie.
Hey, when I get out of this, I'm gonna fucking devolve!
More or less.
Oh, and then there's iconic animation voice actor Tom Kenny, SpongeBob SquarePants himself. What's his role? Scatter, the incoherent sex, drug, and violence-fueled chimpanzee only capable of making monkey noises? Yeah, so worth it. And of course, Priscilla Presley is portrayed by the idol herself, allowing the world to see the couple interact once more in what we are sure are genuine recreations of key marital moments.
Great show, Satin. I loved it.
And love you.
The karate was different.
Yeah, sorry about that, Ronnie.
All good.
Walk it off, big guy.
He's gonna be okay, right?
Oh, shit, yeah. Ronnie's a pro.
So, when exactly does Agent Elvis take place? 1968 to 1973. A bit of a tumultuous time in American cultural history, to say the least. We're talking about the height of the Vietnam War, Watergate, and countercultural movements galore.
And to think this all started with a kid named yours truly buying a $7 guitar at Tupelo Hardware.
Good God. Guess we can go ahead and check the healthy self-image box.
And the show follows historic moments to a key, aligning with real dates like the King's 68 comeback special, his 1970 photo op with Nixon, the 1973 Aloha from Hawaii via satellite. The list goes on. And who's to say Elvis doesn't have a bigger mark on history than we might have assumed? After all, intel on TCB operations and operatives is highly confidential. This is absolutely a show that will reward history buffs. Not that that's in any way necessary to fall in love with the series. The show is a total time capsule, just presented through a fresh modern animation style and very modern sense of humor.
Now you listen to me, scumbag. I promise you, Scatter's gonna pull that trigger.
Oh, fuck!
If! God damn it, Scatter, I was gonna say if he didn't talk!
Not sticking up for the chimp here, boss, but it was a little confusing.
Agent Elvis is more than another adult animation series. It's a lens into a storied piece of history, a gut-busting comedy unafraid to push buttons or envelopes, an adrenaline-fueled secret agent romp sure to keep audiences on the edge of their seats, a show the likes of which we've never seen before, for an icon the likes of which the world will never forget.